Let's therefore raise the big questions tonight. The reopening of schools, is it timely or hasty? Should we first be aiming to vaccinate children before we allow them to enter schools, or certainly their parents should be fully vaccinated? Will a third wave hit children more, or is that another alarmist signal? Are there lessons to be learned from the US surge, where children are among those affected at the moment? Joining me now is Dr. Usha Ram, educationist, joins me. Dr. Chandrakant Laheria, epidemiologist. Dr. P. Sarat Chandra, professor, Department of Neurosciences. Reena Gupta is ARP spokesperson. Dr. Sarda Srinivasan is pediatrician. And Aparajita Gautam is president, Delhi Parents Association. We've got lots of voices because this is a issue which sort of tends to divide people a fair amount. Let's go one by one and get each of your voices in on this as to where you stand. Dr. Usha Ram, you want to start first. As an educationist, are you happy that today's schools have begun or not?
Without saying that, it's a mixed feeling. We cannot say that we are very happy. Mm-hmm. There's no other choice. Let's understand that, you know, we have to take all the precautions. That is what we are doing. We are asking the parents also to give it in writing. They've got the vaccination done. The school itself is asking we have got the report of each and every teacher, worker, that they've got vaccinated. When it comes to children, distancing, keeping, you know, a little bit of distance from each other, and, you know, social distancing in any case, and hand wash, and, you know, trying to keep themselves mask on their faces. See, we have no other choice. Let's understand that there are many...
But is it foolproof? No. Dr. Usha Ram, is it foolproof? Can you tell me that every child who came to school today, their parents are fully vaccinated?
No, it's not foolproof. But what I'm trying to tell you that we have no other choice than to find a via media, because the children, you know, otherwise their well-being, their mental health will get disturbed. We are talking about the competency-based learning. We are talking about learning outcomes. How do we work out all that?
Sure.
So blended learning... And then the hybrid learning, all these, you know, we have already started that. Those who can come, fine. If you can't come, blended learning is there. You have the hybrid learning also. You can have online, offline.
Okay.
So that the system goes on.
Okay, so you believe there was no option but to open the school. Aparajita Gautam, President, Delhi Parents Association. Are parents just happy to have their kids out of home and back in classes? Learning online was a huge challenge for many. So do you believe at the end of the day, the best place for our children are schools?
See, thank you, Mr. Rajdeep. Schools to definitely, they are the best place. But problem is that hame pata hai ki third wave aa rahi hai. और बहुत सारे स्टेट्स में जहां जहां पर भी स्कूल्स खुले हैं, वी कैन डेफिनेटली सी द डेटा, इट इज ऑलरेडी देयर इन द न्यूज, आप लोग भी दिखा रहे हैं, जहां पर हम लोग अगर देखें जो स्पाइक हुआ है 150% तक गया है, तो आप ये बताइए कि जहां पे नया स्कूल कहीं पर भी स्टेट में खुल रहा है, और आउट ऑफ 36 हम स्टेट्स और यूनियन टेरिटरीज लेते हैं, 7 अभी ओपन है, यानी कि 20% ओनली मान रहे हैं कि स्कूल्स को ओपन करना चाहिए. तो पेरेंट्स का पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू है, 80% पेरेंट्स आज भी स्कूल भेजने के लिए तैयार नहीं है.
अपरजीता, आपने अपने बच्चे को स्कूल भेजा था? आपने अपने बच्चों को स्कूल भेजा था आज?
जी, मैंने बिल्कुल नहीं भेजा. मैं उसके पीछे रीजन भी बताती हूँ. यही हम बताना चाह रहे हैं कि गवर्नमेंट दूसरा आस्पेक्ट ये नहीं देख रही है कि जिनके घर में कोरोना के केसेस हुए हैं, वहां पर सीवियर जिनको प्रॉब्लम हुई है, आज भी लंग फाइब्रोसिस से वो लोग जूझ रहे हैं. तो ये वो लोग हैं जिनको कभी बेड नहीं मिला, दवाइयां टाइम से नहीं मिली. हम नहीं चाहते जो सिचुएशन हमने सेकेंड फेज में देखा था, वो हम अपने बच्चों के लिए देखें. क्योंकि आज आप मुझसे पर्सनली पूछ रहे हैं, सर मैं आपको बता देती हूँ, वी लॉस्ट आवर फादर इन लॉ. इसके चक्कर में रीजन, क्योंकि फैसिलिटीज अवेलेबल नहीं थी. मैं नहीं देख सकती ना सिर्फ अपने बच्चे को या किसी और बच्चे को, क्योंकि यही फियर हर पेरेंट में है कि किस तरीके से स्कूल नॉर्म्स को फॉलो करेंगे.
अपरजीता, आप कह रही हैं कि ये फियर फैक्टर अभी भी है, आप थर्ड वेव से डरती है. चंद्रकांत लहरिया, एपिडेमोलॉजिस्ट, यू हैव बीन अ ग्रेट एडवोकेट दैट स्कूल्स मस्ट स्टार्ट. हियर यू आर हियरिंग द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ द दिल्ली पेरेंट्स एसोसिएशन सेइंग आई एम नॉट सेंडिंग माय चाइल्ड टू स्कूल, आई फियर द वर्स्ट.
So this is very important that school opening is not based upon personal opinion or common sense. What we should do, we should use scientific and epidemiological evidence to open school. And there is enough evidence to say that schools can be opened safely. what we need to remember that if a parent, any parent or any family member is going out and coming back to the house, then sending a child to the school risk is far lower because a child is getting exposed. If you can, if any parent is taking out their child to a market or mall, then sending the child to the school risk is far lower. So essentially, the only condition I would say that people should not send their child to school is that they are not, none of the family member is going out and coming in, or child has never, is not going to step out of the house. But if child has stepped out of the house, you can safely send children to the school. Other thing is that what we need to remember that there is no additional risk in sending children to the school. There are many misconceptions that vaccines would be available, then only children can be sent to the school. That is not true. So what I would advise that we need to pay a little more attention. We need to talk to other parents and other individuals who understand the topic better. Finally, I would say that one of the key thing concern is that, okay, in Punjab, in Karnataka, in Odisha, wherever schools were opened, the number of cases increased. I think that's a misinterpretation of data. What happens that many of the states which have opened the school increased the testing in the schools. And what they found, because they increased the number of testing, the number of positive children came out higher, more than the previous, before the schools were open. But that does not mean infection increase. It simply means more infections were detected. And we know that children do get infected. And we are at this stage, we are not concerned about infections only because everybody has infection one form. We are concerned about more moderate to severe disease and illness, which is not increasing due to schools. And that is true for India, US, or any other setting. Infections might increase or maybe detected more, but that is
so
not.
So you're saying there is no correlation. There is no correlation between opening up of schools and infections increasing, even in the United States, where, remember, this is becoming a major talking point. Let me get more voices. Dr. Shardar Srinivas, you're a pediatrician. Do you support the view that children should be out there? Do you fear any risk? You heard a parent, Aparajita Gautam, fearing that children will be affected by a potential third wave. Is that being alarmist? Is that, again, creating fears where none exist? Children, according to most epidemiologists, including Dr. Leria, are least prone to coronavirus.
Yes. Hi, good evening. It is a very paradoxical situation. I mean, we're opening schools when we're expecting a third wave and children are at highest risk and they're not vaccinated. Yes, all that exists. But if you look at the picture at large, I think children have been shut out from school for the last almost 500 days. And that is a mighty long time for children to be sitting indoors. Now, we cannot predict the future. I mean, COVID is not going to go away. Even if the third wave does or doesn't come, the situation, it's going to simmer and it's going to be there as an endemic disease even for the next couple of years. So keeping that in mind, children are not actually devoid of risks if they go to school, because we cannot postpone the school reopening forever and ever.
Right.
Sometime we have to
You're also saying no time is a good time. Every time, you know, you can't say this is the perfect time. You just have to take your chances. Dr. Sarath Chandra, Professor, Department of Neurosciences, do you agree with that? There is no time like a good time. I mean, if you look at numbers, the numbers at the moment clearly seem to suggest that COVID cases among children below the age of 17 are completely under control. Is it a risk worth taking, therefore, by opening up schools?
Well, Rajdeep, I would like to voice as a physician. Now, here I would like to quote a very well-known theory called as a cheese hole theory. So you have number of holes in cheese, you know, and if all the holes are aligned, and that is where you can have the visual axis completely seen. So it's the same thing with COVID. So in COVID control, we don't have one strategy. We have multiple strategies. And hence, all the strategies have to be in place. Now, in context to school, what I would like to state, it's not a question of children going to school. It's a question of what are the precautions which are being taken by the people at school or administrators at school. And I can kind of suggest a 10-point agenda, what has to be done. For instance, there should be a 10 minutes at the assembly every day where the teachers and the principal have to emphasize COVID-appropriate behavior, because this is usually fizzles out. You know, we usually become lackadaisical over a period of time. It's very mandatory
so
that
one.
All
number two?
Teachers, workers, and drivers are fully vaccinated. No visitors should be allowed.
Okay.
Correct mask application okay. should be there. No food sharing should be allowed. The toilet should be really ventilated and they should be well sanitized. Dispersal after the school mm-hmm. should be in a phased out manner. So these are all the precautions mm-hmm. which have to be taken. It's like the cheese roll. If all the precautions are taken, it's unlikely that there is going to be any outbreak. So what is important from my perspective as a physician?
You're saying, Dr. Chandra, that unless those precautions are taken, in your view, the schools, there needs to be almost an accountability on the part of the school. That the schools have to be accountable to the children and if they and the parents. And if they don't follow these precautions that you're putting in place, then you believe this doesn't work. Am I correct?
Absolutely. So the precautions have to be followed.
But who,
so we do the same thing in hospital.
But how are you going to ensure that?
How did we stop the spread of COVID among healthcare workers? We had to follow sure. each and every precaution.
But how are you?
So the same thing has to be applied.
But how are you going to ensure that is the big challenge? Reena Gupta, the Aam Aadmi Party spokesperson. I am in Mumbai at the moment. In Mumbai, schools have not opened. Because Mumbai, the administration believes that you've got to be much more cautious before you open up schools, that the city is not ready. Delhi, on the other hand, has taken this big decision. We've also seen many of the southern states taking the decision. Have you all done a complete review? Or is it simply pressure from various stakeholders that has forced you to open up schools? Is this based on clear data? Or is this simply a punt that you all are taking?
So, Rajdeep, the Delhi government has opened the schools and the decision has been taken after a very systematic review and has been very participatory. And it is not a knee-jerk reaction. This is something that we've been preparing for days now. The education minister himself held several meetings with the principals, with parents and with students. Everybody overwhelmingly has been requesting, please open the schools. More than 70% of the parents wanted the schools to be open. Having said that, what we are saying is that we are not forcing the parents to send their children to school. Delhi government schools will continue offline and online mode. So if the parents are not comfortable, they don't need to send their children to school. Also, one has to understand there is a big digital divide. The families that the Delhi government schools cater to are families where children are living in extremely, extremely small, tiny houses. And parents have been telling us that they want the schools to open so that the children are able to come out. We have been working with the principals and the teachers to ensure that proper COVID behavior is followed. It's going to be only 50% attendance. There is going to be a scanner at every entrance point. We are ensuring that all the workers, the teachers, the principals are all vaccinated. Wherever they're not vaccinated, vaccination of the school staff is being done on a priority basis. And the government is monitoring the situation very, very, very closely. So, opening a school actually needs a lot of effort. Closing is a very simple thing. If we see that number of cases rise, then closing is a half an hour decision. We can again go back and close the schools. But what we've seen, Rajdeep, is that the children have been going through a very tough time staying at home. In fact, the education minister, in his meeting with the principals,
I completely agree with you.
The first few days, I would completely agree with you.
Sure, I could completely agree that having a system which is purely online has caused enormous damage in terms of the hybrid model. Aparijita Gautam, you're listening to all the voices. Ab to thodi santushti hui ki nahi? Kal apne beti bete ko bhejogi ki nahi school? Are you willing to send them? Itna dar kyon hai?
राजदीप जी, आपके पैनल के थ्रू, आपके चैनल के थ्रू हम ये कन्वे करना चाहते हैं, यहाँ जितने भी दलीलें दी जा रही हैं, ग्राउंड रियलिटी में वो कुछ नहीं होता. हम बात कर रहे थे अभी अकाउंटेबिलिटी की. अकाउंटेबिलिटी जीरो अकाउंटेबिलिटी है. ये हम क्यों कह रहे हैं, क्योंकि फेब और मार्च में भी हमने देखा था. यहाँ पर मिसेस गुप्ता हैं जिन्होंने बताया कि गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग सो मच ऑफ केयर. तब गवर्नमेंट कहाँ थी जब फेब और मार्च में जब बच्चे कह रहे थे कि नहीं हमारा ऑफलाइन करवाइए. मैं माफी चाहूंगी आपके चैनल के थ्रू, जहां पे शिक्षा मंत्री दूसरे स्टेट में जाके या केंद्र सरकार को कह रहे थे कि 10th और 12th के आप एग्जाम जो है कैंसिल कीजिए या ऑनलाइन लीजिए, आप अपने ही स्टेट में बच्चों के ऑफलाइन एग्जाम ले रहे थे. दूसरी बात जो इन्होंने बात कही है, दूसरी बात आपको बता देती हूँ, इन्होंने कहा है कि किसी के ऊपर फोर्स नहीं किया जा रहा. आप बिलीव कीजिए, सुबह से हमारे पास इतनी कंप्लेंट्स आ रही हैं लेट मी गिव यू वन एग्जांपल, आइडियल स्कूल के कितने पेरेंट्स की हमारे पास कंप्लेंट्स आई हैं कि आज उन्होंने अगर बच्चों को नहीं भेजा है तो उनकी ऑनलाइन क्लास साइमल्टेनियसली नहीं चली है। साफ साफ बोल दिया गया है कि आपके बच्चे का एब्सेंट लगेगा। आप ये मुझे बताइए, आपके चैनल के माध्यम से इसको मैं कन्वे क्यों नहीं करूं? क्यों नहीं स्कूल ट्रस्ट गेन करने की कोशिश कर रहे? दूसरी बात, मेरे बात करते करते आप यहाँ पर एक वीडियो चला रहे थे जहाँ पे सारे मिलकर डांस कर रहे हैं। आप मुझे बताइए, कोविड प्रोटोकॉल में 2 गज की दूरी भी जरूरी है, साथ साथ सट के सारे डांस कर रहे हैं, आज उसको एंजॉय करें। दिस इज नॉट अ फेस्टिवल। स्कूल ओपन हुआ है, आई डू अंडरस्टैंड, okay. बच्चे खुश हैं, सब खुश हैं। इट डजंट मीन कि आप रेड कार्पेट बिछाकर बच्चों को बुलाएं। आप देखिए अभी भी सारे डांस कर रहे, बच्चे पास पास खड़े हुए हैं। दिस इटसेल्फ शोज कि कोविड प्रोटोकॉल्स फॉलो नहीं किए जा रहे हैं। आप ही अपने चैनल के
मैम यू आर यू सीम टू बी एन यू नो यू I can understand your concerns also as a parent, just as I can understand why schools want to open these. Rajiv, this is a very, it's an emotive Rajiv issue, ma'am. But Dr. Usha Ram, Dr. Usha Ram, you want to, in a way, you know, how can schools ensure that these protocols are maintained? You know, I go to school, I want to play with my friends, I'm going to be out there. How are you going to maintain distancing? How are you going to ensure this? You know, the political class, you know, the Aam Aadmi Party and other parties across the country can say this is what majority of parents want. And that may well be true. But the fact is that how are you going to ensure the safety on a day-to-day basis?
See, it is very clear that we are going to have the timetable, you know, divided in such a manner so that, you know, they come during their, you know, period. They are not there. They are in the other room. They are not in that activity room. See, we have to really, people have planned out. I can understand, I can see the mother still her face, you know, and I can understand her, you know, anxiety. But let's explain that, you know, we are trying our best. We are working out in such a manner that, you know, there is a social distancing. There is the, you know, children wearing the mask. And then on both the sides, so we have to prepare our parents. If you are not interested, okay, go for hybrid. Go for blended teaching. Who stops you? We are not saying that all. I don't know why you are saying that, you know, some schools are saying that you have to come. I don't think it's compulsory. If you are not interested to come to send your child to school, it's all right. You can have the blended learning. Mm-hmm. You can have the hybrid learning. Now, even the cloud technology is there. There's so many other things which have come up.
No, sure. But, you know, all of this, ma'am, as we are seeing a lot of these models actually, you know, look good on paper. In practice, as was pointed out by Reena Gupta of the Aam Aadmi Party, there are parents who live in very small houses who are struggling with online. The affluent can get away with online learning. Those who do not have access to modern technology are suffering. So digital divide is a major issue at the moment. But I just want to understand once and for all the health concerns, Dr. Laharia. Children, and this is the United States example, and I'll come to that and I'll give you some facts there. The American Academy of Pediatrics, 204,000 COVID-19 cases in children. Children now represent 22.4% of new COVID-19 cases. Between August 20 and 26, an average of 330 children were admitted to hospitals every day in the United States with COVID-19. Why don't both you and Dr. Sharda Srinivas take that first? You, Dr. Laharia, these numbers, they're staring at us. It seems that it is important to protect children also against COVID.
So what we need to remember that children do get infected. There is no denial that children do not get infected. And that's what has happened in India. 60% of Indian children have been found to have antibody in fourth nationwide sero survey. But what is important that children do not develop moderate to severe disease and illness. And now going back to United States number, as you highlighted, that the number of infection have increased and higher, but the proportion number of children who required admission, as you say, is around 330, while as far as I remember, the number of hospital admission in the United States is really very high. So even the proportion of hospitalized children remain really low. That's one point. Second point, we need to remember that virus is there and it causes infection, but India is very different from United States. India had a severe second wave and majority of population has already been infected. In other settings where vaccination has been done for adults, the children remain uninfected, or that's why there is more cases are coming in children. But we are not concerned about cases. We are concerned about moderate to severe illness, which there is no evidence is increasing. even due to Delta variant. There is no evidence that Delta variant also caused moderate to severe.
You're saying there is no evidence of moderate to severe diseases being caused among children because of Delta variant. Do you agree with that, Dr. Sharda Srinivas? Has that been your experience also there in Chennai?
Yes. Most of the children sail through these infections. It's like a mild cold cough or a flu-like illness, and it just passes off in 2 or 3 days. Majority of the children present that way. It's a very, very few of them get into complications such as hyperinflammatory, multisystemic inflammatory syndrome disease. That's a very exceptional complication which we always look out for. But majority of them sail through it. And we have to weigh the pros and cons. What about the other aspects? I mean, obesity is on the rise for these children. And most of these children are having a mental shutdown. Depression is really high. They're having hyperactivity disorders because they're not meant to live cooped up in a one-bedroom apartment. Children are meant to go out and be in the open and play, mingle with their peers. And they big impact on
the two strongest arguments in a sense to get children back in school are the psychological impact that living at home for such a long time is having. Second is, of course, the digital divide, which clearly is a major issue at the moment. Reena Gupta, you still want to answer the parent who's still anxious? She feels that you've done this without adequate groundwork in place, is her fear. That it's all very well to say here in the studio that don't worry, everything will be fine. Parents feel that that they don't have trust in your system. The system lacks trust.
So Rajdeep, all I want to say is that parents, government, teachers, principal, children, we are all in this together. You know, COVID is the new normal. Mm-hmm. And we cannot afford to have a generation with such a big learning gap. So the schools would need to open. We all need to work together to make sure that COVID appropriate behavior is followed. And if there are any breaches, then we will all need to again work together and make sure that, you know, we're doing everything in
the right
way.
So what will you do if a school breaches it? What if you find out, if parents provide you evidence that a school has breached COVID appropriate behavior, what action do you take?
Of course, Rajdeep, we will make sure that the school is penalized and the people responsible are penalized so that such behavior is not, the others are make sure that this, COVID appropriate behavior is followed. So, as I said, the government is monitoring the situation very, very closely, Rajdeep. And if we see
how
that
will you
it is
monitor
not
it?
Possible
how will you
to,
monitor on a day-to-day basis hundreds of schools?
Various district level committees have been formed, Rajdeep, especially for this purpose, that are monitoring this situation on a day-to-day basis. And you know, as I said in the beginning, we've been preparing for this for weeks. It's not like today we've taken this decision. And right now, when the number of COVID cases and new cases in Delhi are hardly 30 to 35, if we don't do it now, when are we going to do it? And as I said,
that's
digital divide is a big issue.
Sure. You know, the fact is, no time, Dr. Chandra, is a good time. You know, I said this earlier. We now seem to have at the moment this, between what happened terribly in April, May, the second wave, and fears of a third wave, at the moment, by and large, across the country, numbers are under control. And therefore, this is being seen in large parts of the country as the right time to do so. Do you go along with that, or do you go along with the view in Mumbai? The view in Mumbai, Dr. Chandra, is very different. The view in Mumbai is that this needs to be done only at a time when the situation, when all fears of third wave are over. Which way do you go? The Delhi way or the Mumbai way?
So, Rajdeep, I would say that whether we like it or not, COVID is here to stay. It's a pandemic. It would become endemic. Now, for 2 years, we've been learning all about COVID appropriate behavior. Everybody is aware of COVID appropriate behavior. We need to bring out SOPs for all areas, especially schools, on what are the proper SOPs to be followed. It could be a 10-point agenda or an 8-point agenda. It's very important that the teachers emulate these behaviors and they ensure, and once they start taking precautions, the children will also start taking precautions. Personally, I feel No, but then, I personally
no, but the fact is, the fact, doctor, I'm sorry to sound cynical. The fact, doctor, is that you can't have different rules for different groups. You know, now college students are saying, what about us? Why aren't you? We are actually vaccinated. Those in the 18 to 21 group are vaccinated, but colleges are closed. So, I mean, do you just open up India? Is that the answer? Unless you are a containment zone where cases are high, open up the rest of the country.
Well, Rajdeep, I will not go into those areas. All I can say is that as long as you follow COVID appropriate behavior and they are regimentally followed, we can take this decision. And I think it's a good calculated risk. But the issue is that
it's a good calculated risk
to the dot.
I think that's a good way to put it, that this is a good calculated risk. Aparajita Gautam, you've got to take a risk at some stage in life. Aap puri duniya apne bachcho ko ghar pe bithakar nahi sikha sakti. I'm sure your children also want to go to school and play with their friends, be in a physical class, offline learning. Nothing is better than that. Online jitna bhi karo, end of the day, you need that interaction.
Can I speak?
जब नीति आयोग ने भी आपका प्रिडिक्शन दे दिया है 3 से 4 लाख केसेस आएंगे सितंबर में से, कांट बी वेट फॉर अनदर 2 मंथ्स, ऐसी कौन सी हश हश वाली सिचुएशन आ गई है कि हम 2 महीना वेट नहीं कर सकते? ऐसे पेरेंट हम कह रहे हैं, हम आप दूसरा मैं बताती हूँ डॉक्टर,
नवंबर में भी आप ऐसा ही कहेंगी, नवंबर में आप कहेंगी और 2 महीने ले लीजिए।
राजदीप जी आप सुन लीजिए, दिस इज नॉट माय पर्सनल, 80% पेरेंट्स जो हैं वोटिंग के थ्रू, पोल के थ्रू उन्होंने अपना अपना डिसीजन जाहिर किया है।
नो दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट, नो मैम, मैम दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट सेड 90% ऑफ द पेरेंट्स इन दिल्ली वांटेड स्कूल्स टू स्टार्ट, यू आर सेइंग 80% पेरेंट्स डिडंट वांट स्कूल टू स्टार्ट,
देन लेट दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट शेयर द डेटा, कहां पर है उनका डेटा? दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट का कोई डेटा नहीं है। आप मुझसे पूछेंगे, मैं इनके डेटा की बात करूं, एसएमसी में आई एम सॉरी टू से आम आदमी पार्टी के वर्कर्स बैठे हुए हैं, पीटीए मीटिंग में अगर प्राइवेट स्कूल्स के पीटीएस की बात करें, वहां पर पीटीए नहीं होती है, वो स्कूल मैनेजमेंट के अपने रिप्रेजेंटेटिव होते हैं। और रीना गुप्ता जी ने कहा था पिनलाइज करेंगे, मैडम आप ये बताइए 1.5 साल में कितने स्कूलों को दिल्ली के पिनलाइज किया है? हम लोगों ने पर्सनली आपको हजारों मेल्स भेजी है, सिंगल स्कूल भी पिनलाइज होता तो आप मेरा ट्रस्ट गेन करते, आपके इसी चैनल में आकर मैं भी इसी बात को सपोर्ट करती, स्कूल खोलने चाहिए और हम भी अपने बच्चों को भेजेंगे। प्रॉब्लम ये है जब बच्चों को हरास किया जाता है, कोई नहीं सुनता। मैं सबसे नीचे के जोन ऑफिसर से लेकर टॉप मोस्ट की बात करूं, हमारे सीएम तक ने भी एक गुहार नहीं सुनी गई है, जहां पे स्कूल ने अगर क्लास से बच्चों को निकाल दिया। और आज आपके चैनल के माध्यम से मैंने एक स्कूल का नाम लेते हुए आपको बताया, क्या आप स्कूल के ऊपर एक्शन लेंगे? मैं आपको रिटर्न में आपको कल मॉर्निंग
ओके, सो यू आर सेइंग स्कूल, ओके यू मेड योर पॉइंट मैम, आई लेट मी गो टू उषा राम फॉर अ फाइनल वर्ड, व्हाट वर यू ट्राइंग टू से उषा राम?
आई वाज ट्राइंग टू से दैट यू नो confidence building with the parent group is very important. Yes. We need to have a very good networking with the parents, talk to them, discuss with them. It has to be school-wise. We cannot say the whole of Delhi or whole of government schools or the private schools. We have to take individual schools have to take the responsibility, and we have to talk to our parents, get them into confidence, let them understand. Those who can send the children, they should send.
Ma'am,
no compulsion, nothing should be there. But it is necessary.
Well, the fact is there is a trust deficit. The fact is, while the doctors by and large seem to be supporting the decision, the fact is there still is, it appears at least on this show, an element of a trust deficit between parents and the schools. And unless that trust deficit is overcome, this is going to be a major challenge. However, my own view is there is no time. There is no good time. Better late than never. Schools are, our children need to be out and have offline classes. We cannot have a digital divide being sustained in our schools beyond a point. What Delhi has done today, other states like Puducherry, Tamil Nadu have done a few weeks ago, it's time possibly to take it across the country. A good calculated risk is perhaps the best way to put what's happening. Thank you all very much for joining us. We will keep monitoring that very closely. Remember, as we said, the United States in particular is an example of what's gone wrong at times if you open up without putting adequate precautions in place.